good morning, everyone. So we're in West Vancouver today. It's late January. What is it, 19th?
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's quite warm.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Sun's beaming down and it's close to 10 degrees and we're probably in the warmest place in Canada right now. So we're going to go crabbing today. So wintertime, it's the best time to go crabbing in Vancouver because the commercial season is in the summertime, right?
Yeah.
I think it starts around May.
Yeah.
It goes right through the summer. So that's when the crabbing pressure is quite high. Generally, if you come around January, between January and April,
yep.
It's the best time because lots of crabs around. So this is my friend Rick. Rick's is a pro staff at Gibbs Dollar Tackle, and he's generous enough to take us out today, do a bit of crabbing, and we're going to do a bit of fishing while we wait for the crabs to come in the trap. So let's get started. We got the crab traps right here. And yeah, so we just got to bait them up. So one thing about crabbing is you got to have very, very smelly bait to attract the crab into the trap. So what we have here is I brought some old salmon parts which has been marinated in this gooey, I guess, red stuff. And that is this bottle right here. That's Pautzke's crab and shrimp fuel. And this gives a bit more extra scent. I mean, the salmon itself is already pretty smelly, but having that juice that will disperse in the water will attract the crab all around the trap to come in the area. So let's take this out.
Sure. What I think we're going to do is stuff is a little on the messy side.
Oh, let's put this in a bucket you know what? Let's put this in here so if the juice falls out, we don't get it all over the boat.
Sure.
And that boat will be smelly. And that I wouldn't be invited back for a long time.
All right, so how many pieces do you have in here?
You know what? I think there was at least six or seven.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So we have a bait bag, just a standard salmon or a bait bag. And if you have six, maybe we'll put two each.
Yeah, okay. And see how many we have left.
Sure, you bet.
I guess, the end.
And so we're just going to snap that to the inside of the trap. Like so.
So each side of the trap, you have this little gate that the crab will go in. Once they get in, they can't get out, right? Because it's a one-way street.
And we have our float and our weighted line. And I have my float marked with my name and my boat number. Super important, as per the regulations. And I've got a little metal carabiner that I use just to snap that onto the crab trap harness.
How many traps can you have?
Per license, you're allowed to run two.
Two traps.
And today I brought three since we have three people here with licenses. But per license, you're allowed to run two.
Right. And when we talk about licenses, it's a saltwater fishing license
you gotta have. Saltwater. Yeah.
As long as you buy a saltwater fishing license, you can go fishing, but also go crabbing with that as well.
Yeah, you don't need any special licenses for that.
Yep.
That's good.
So how long do you soak these guys for?
As long as you can. The longer you can soak them, the better. You know, it's my hope today, maybe we can get 4 or 5 hours down.
Right.
The longer you soak, the better.
Yeah.
I've soaked them as short as 4 hours and as many as 6 to 8 hours.
Right,
so,
right. And that's why it's so important to have really scented bait, right?
Yeah,
you want that bait to last.
The Pautzke stuff that you're using, you know, the concept there is that it really draws the crabs in.
Yeah.
And the meat, the theory is that the scent draws them in, and the meat is what kind of keeps them there. It gives them something to munch on.
Yeah.
Feet. Everything's hooked up.
Okay, so now that the traps are set, we have 4 or 5 hours to kill. We're going to go out a little bit to about 30 feet of water, anchor, and we'll do a bit of fishing. Most people come out here in the wintertime to try to target Chinook salmon, but today we're going to do something a little different, and we'll tell you what it is once we anchor the boat. So we're going to start fishing now. We got the anchor set at about 30 feet or what? 34?
Yeah,
okay.
30,
so usually in the wintertime, Rick comes out for Chinook salmon. He trolls for winter feeders around this whole area, which can be pretty good between, I guess, January and April.
Pretty much up to March-ish.
Yeah, these fish are looking for herring and other kind of bait fish.
Yep.
But we're not going to do that today. we're going to be fishing for something a little different that most people don't actually fish for in BC.
No.
In the saltwater around Vancouver, there is a variety of fish species, including dogfish, flatfish, and tomcod, greenling, and a whole bunch of small bottom feeders that people don't normally talk about, but it's actually pretty fun, especially for kids, right?
Oh, for sure.
Because there are lots of them. First of all, there's lots of them, and they're always willing to bite, regardless what time of the year. Well, I hope. Yeah. Maybe we'll end up with nothing at all today.
No, they're biting.
Yeah.
They'll be
Who
here.
Knows, yeah. And the third thing is the most exciting part, which I find is you never know what you're going to get, because there's so many different species. When you get a bite, it could be a big fish, could be a small fish. You just never know. Trying to get this entangled here so I can show you guys what we're using. I'm actually just using a three-way bottom rig, which I tied up last night. That's why it's all tangled up in the box.
It wouldn't be fishing if you weren't, you know, untangling. There you go.
There you go, yeah. So this is the three-way rig, which is tied up. So I got the weight on the bottom that will anchor right on the bottom, and this will suspend a little bit above. And you're using like a slider.
Yeah, I'm using more like almost a sturgeon rig.
Yeah.
With a, you know, some leader, just a regular.
Yeah, like a 1.5 leader, a weight that slides up and down.
Yeah.
Right? So, and we're not using very heavy weight. There's not a whole lot of current right now.
No.
The tide change is pretty small this afternoon.
Yeah, it's a decent.
Yeah, so we don't need a whole lot of weight. So this will just go on my light spinning outfit, because you're not fishing for a fish that's really big. We're not fishing for halibut. You want to use the right tackle for the right species. So we're using very, very light spinning outfit. This is a 2 to 6 pound test spinning rod. And on my other rod, which I'm hoping to get a dogfish on, which is rated 8 to 12 pound, which is And that's the rod I use for spinning for salmon. I'll set that up as well. And for bait, what are you using for bait, Rick?
I brought a couple things. I brought a nice herring that I'm going to cut in little teeny strips. And I have a few of those. And I also just brought some regular prawn.
Oh, yeah. And I actually brought some squid.
Oh, great.
I just cut up the mantle of the squid into thin long pieces like that, and that was the good thing about squid is it stays on the hook pretty well, whereas I find that prawn tend to fall off quite easily once you get a bite, but we'll see which one works best and we can try different bait. Okay, so let's get going. I'm pretty excited. Okay. I'm all rigged up. Let's get this out there. So it's pretty important to have the rig right on the bottom. That's where all the fish are. One problem we might have is that there are lots of crab around here, so a lot of times they will grab onto your bait. You find that, right?
But it's fun though.
Yeah, it can be. If you want to.
It's not too often that you get a crab on your hook while you're fishing.
Uh-oh.
That was a little aggressive.
Yet. Yeah. Okay. So on my other rod for the dogfish, I got a little, well, not a little, it's a size one circle hook baited with a piece of herring. And this is a Shimano bait runner. This spinning reel here actually has two different drags you can set. So I can leave this as a free spool like that. So the fish will actually pull the line out in the holder if it comes along and grab it. And this reel is normally used for carp fishing and for snapper fishing in Australia. You can just let the fish run for a little bit before you start cranking, set the hook. Oh, there's a fish. I think that's a dogfish.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's a nice starry flounder. Was that on the prawn?
No, herring.
No, herring, huh?
There's a beautiful fish, starry flounder.
Yeah. I've been told that they're not that great for eating. There's also the angry soul in here too, right? I might have to.
Last time we came out here, I actually caught a decent sized one of these rod, and I took it home, and it was actually quite
delicious. Yeah, it was actually quite good.
Here he goes.
Well, I haven't had a bite yet.
What are you fishing again?
I got herring on this one and squid on this one here. I think you gave me the gave me the unlucky side of the boat, Rick, again.
I don't know what this one is.
Oh, that one's fighting pretty good. Oh, that's an even nicer one.
Oh, now that's a nice one.
Well, it's a little nicer.
Incoming. Look at that. Oh, there you go.
No, it came off again. It was a good bite. Hold on. Whoa.
There you go.
No. That's what happens when you use two rods.
Whoa.
Circle hook. That's a dogfish, I think. You see that fish run down? That's pretty exciting. That's a dogfish. Oh, did I get your line?
Yeah.
Somehow. Oh, now we're in trouble.
Let's see.
We're in trouble. Okay. Yeah. We'll put this one right here. So, Is it this one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I think.
Is it?
I think so.
Here we go.
Yeah. All right, dogfish.
You're gonna bring him in here. Let me help you.
Yeah, I'm just gonna move this over the top. Oh, if the fish cooperates. Oh no, that's not good.
This is gonna be awesome footage.
Oh, look at that. That's
okay.
Such
here, let's get him in.
Yeah.
I'll step in.
Okay. That was a fail right there.
It's okay. Oh.
What happened? It's still.
Oh!
You know what happened? Okay, almost.
Okay, so this is what we're gonna do next time.
Yeah.
When we hook one and we know it's a dogfish, I'll immediately go and bring up the other one. Okay? And we'll clear the deck just like.
So sharks have teeth, as we probably didn't know before. And snap my line on this rod here, right on the hook, and then ran to the other line and snapped the main line on this rod.
Oh wow, I didn't even realize that.
So look, we have another dogfish on. It's not gonna pull in line up for some reason. And it came off. Might have to use trace on the instead of using like a mono leader. Because it's cutting it's cutting the hook off, eh?
There you go.
Oh, came off. That didn't feel like a dogfish though.
Oh no?
Yeah. Oh, that was a fish.
Oh, it's a nice one.
Yeah? That's the prong, right?
That's a good pull.
I think that's a dogfish?
Yeah.
Grabbing the prong.
Interesting. Oh yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huh. Would you like me to grab it? I can grab it. Yeah, that's fine.
No, he's here.
Yeah, that's fine. I can grab it. Not so elegant, but Oh! Oh! No, no, that's fine.
Okay.
That's fine. I just don't want to drop that knife in the water. Here we go. So this is a spiny dogfish. And the reason it's called a spiny dogfish, you can see the spine right here. And you definitely don't want to be poked by that. We'll put this guy back here. Okay. You can actually keep this for eating. But we're not going to do that. It's actually pretty tasty. I thought about keeping one just to eat. You can fillet it and skin it and coat it in batter and eat it, right?
Well, there you go.
So two flounders and dogfish, and I still haven't brought a fish into the boat yet. That's not unusual.
What's the score?
What's the score?
No, it's a crab.
Oh, it's a crab.
I've actually hooked it too.
Oh.
Incoming. Right in the mouth.
Yeah, wow.
That's awesome.
That's skill.
Oh.
We're getting bites? Hmm. That's not a dogfish, is it?
It's not a crab? Oh no, it's
a fish. That's a fish.
Oh, it's a sculpin.
Oh.
I think that's what it's called.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just gonna do this bass fishing style.
Bring it up, lip it. Yeah, that's a Pacific staghorn sculpin. Lots of them around. Most people call them bullheads, right? And again, these guys have these little spines on the back. Ooh. You don't want to get poked by those. Wow. It can be very painful. It seems like most of the bottom fish have some kind of
defense mechanism.
Yeah, defense mechanism for to deter the predators and things like that. So it's three species so far: dogfish, flounder, and sculpin. Keeping things interesting. Oh, come on.
Oh. Came off.
Came off. Ooh.
Sure is a lot of fun.
Yeah. A lot of fun watching people catching fish. I'm getting the old bites.
Do you have prawn on?
Nope, I'm still using that squid.
Ooh.
That's another dogfish. That's small taps and I think it's another dogfish. Oh, it came off. Ah, maybe not. Because it didn't really pull down really hard like the other ones, but feels good on the light.
Yeah.
Right,
such a big bend.
Nice bend.
So we've been fishing for a few hours and Rodney hasn't really been able to bring any fish in. Rick's been catching them all. So I thought I'd give it a go and give Rodney a break.
Oh yeah, you got it.
No. Oh no, he's still there.
Oh, that's it.
I'm gonna pull.
There you go, perfect. Is that rod in or out?
It's not, it's out. Dogfish.
Dogfish, nice.
You
want to grab him? Sure.
Take him over here.
Where are the gloves?
Are
there. On the squid?
Yeah, I think it was on the squid, wasn't it? Nice catch. Nice dogfish.
Ooh, he wants to poke me with his spine. Okay, I'm just gonna get that hook out of there.
Oh, right in the mouth. There we go.
Now I'm hooked. There we go.
There we go.
He's bleeding a bit there. That one almost got me. Look at that one.
Got it. Wow.
That's a nice fish. Actually keep that one in. And what I did with the last one is I took the skin off, the top skin off of it. And then I cooked it without the skin. And then once it was cooked, it allowed me to peel the flesh off. And I actually made some fish tacos out of it. And they were killer. So I'm going to keep that.
That's how we eat them in Denmark. Like cook the whole thing.
Yeah.
Just like that.
So I'm going to keep that one.
It's beautiful.
Just picked it
up. Perfect circle hook set. There you go. Let me get this, let me clear the landing strip here.
Well, we got to do everything to so I can land the fish.
Yep. There we go.
Ooh, it's a big one.
Dog?
Yeah.
Step in.
Yeah, grab that.
There we go. Want to bring him in for some shots?
Yeah, sure. It's a pretty big one compared to the other ones. There you go. I finally landed the fish. Nice one. All right. See, the eyes are really big compared to all the fish that we usually catch, eh? Yeah. Okay, well, let's let it go.
You want to let him go?
Oh, you can let it. I'll give you the pleasure for that.
Actually, let's put him in on
the other side. Yeah.
All right.
Well, finally, nice work. I'm not going home skunked. Wow. Right before we're going to go check the crab traps, we've been out here for several hours now. I think the current kind of made it a little bit more challenging today.
Yeah.
At the very beginning when we were fishing, Rick got into quite a few fish because we were fishing that tide change. The tide was just dropping to the lowest and was coming back up again. And last few hours, we had some problem with the current moving too fast and tangling up the line and things like that. So, but now seems a little better now. So we're gonna fish a little longer for maybe 20 minutes, and then we're gonna head over there to check our crab traps and see how many crabs we have.
He's getting some action here. There you go. Nice.
What's that? Oh.
Oh, nice.
Oh, oh, look at that. I can't believe how this little fish swallowed the hook completely. That one size one hook. I'm gonna have to cut this line. Look at that. Oh, fish on. How does that feel?
Doesn't feel...
Oh, yeah, the rod's getting bites too.
Doesn't feel like a dogfish. Feels like something a little lighter.
Oh, oh. The other rod's going, right?
Oh, nice.
Another flounder? Oh, that's pretty nice too.
That's a nice one.
Yeah. Looks like we're in flounder territory here. Few fish in a row.
Starry flounder on the prawn.
Mm-hmm. Beauty.
Send that one back. Woo!
What is going on here? No comment.
Oh, another flounder.
Lots of bites now.
No. Are you fishing prawn?
Yeah, this one's on prawn. I was getting bites when you were reeling that in.
I think I might go for double prawn and try for the double header.
Oh, another one.
What do you got this time?
I think that's another dogfish. Oh no, it's a flounder.
Oh nice.
So we need to have a bunch of flounders here. Another one.
Nice size.
Yeah. Good way to finish the day finally. Started catching fish, now we have to go home.
You got that on the squid?
Yeah, that was on the squid. It's been chewing on that squid for a while now, actually. All right.
Off you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, what do you say?
Okay, let's go check the crab trap. See how many we got.
So we'll get this one first.
Let's see if this works.
Ah, I didn't get it!
Sorry.
That was a fail.
Well, it was too close to the boat. That's my excuse.
Ah,
okay, I got it.
So can we float into the boat? Don't let go of the float.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, feels heavy, that's a good sign.
Yeah, Rick says that every time we put in the trap. Feels good.
Octopus.
There is some weight to it. They've been down, how long have they been down now? 5 hours, 6 hours?
Yeah, something like that.
It's a good. Oh. Coming up.
And overboard.
Oh yeah.
Six and a half. It's this one right here. Yeah, that one's right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Well, we put all three traps up and we actually have lots of crab in the, as expected, probably 15 in each trap, something like that. But most of them were undersized, but they weren't like really undersized, they were just undersized by a few millimeters. And of course we had to play by the rules and let the ones that are undersized go, and we still got a few nice legal sized crab, like this one right here, beautiful crab, and that'll be good dinner tonight. And, but yeah, definitely come out and try it. Rick is thinking this is a little early in the season.
Yeah, you know, it's been a funny early crab season. We're getting traps that are full, and the crabs are just like just undersized.
Yeah.
And I think that if we come out in, you know, maybe as the season ages a bit, maybe into March, you know, you might
see. March, they might grow a little bit more, and then it'll be legal.
Yeah, it's a little discouraging, though, because you've got a crab traps full of crabs, you know, but sometimes it goes that way.
Yeah, definitely. Well, we just have to come back again and try
maybe
it
that.
Okay, well, let's go home.
All right.
Well, thanks for the invite again, Rick.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Pleasure.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thanks for putting on the show, catching all the fish, making me look bad.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah,
so
definitely we'll do it again.
Sure.
Okay, well, let's go.